Okay, good. Good to hear. Now, we are recording, and we'll start the show in 5, 4, 3, 2. What's up, Press Play fans? It's time for another Steampunks, and I'm joined today by Mr. Peter Kendall from How Do I Jump.
Hey.
How
you doing, sir?
Chris Nodge is not on this show, but we have another How Do I Jump guy. How Do I Jump? Always represented on our show. Almost always.
I am actually personally happy that I beat Chris out finally. He's shown up on a lot more of these than I have, so I gotta get up on that.
Step up your game.
Dude.
And today we are stepping up Peter's game by playing Full Boar, which is, as you might expect, a game where you play as a boar and you bore into the walls of a mine. It's a really weird but charming game. Let's check it out.
This is
Full Boar. Oh, I'm resuming game. Okay, so I'm this boar.
Oh my
boar
god,
here.
You're already playing.
Yeah. I think the best way to show it off might be to start a new.
Oh my god, is this Spelunky game? With a boar? Is this Spelunky with
a boar?
Well,
it's not a roguelike. It's more like, it's kind of like that game Escape Goat a little bit. Sort of also recently came out, the Escape Goat 2, because you are playing as an animal and you are doing puzzles. So I'll just start from the start, sort of. I think it has a nice little opening. And also, you can choose if you want to be Frederick or Hildy. What are you thinking?
They're both still
a boar. Well, they're boars, but one is a girl boar, one is a boy boar, I guess.
Let's be a girl boar. Let's be nice.
There boars? Can a boar be a girl? I thought boar was like the male version of
like a fawn is like a baby deer. I think it's just same.
Okay. So we're running around. We are boars.
Are we a little girl? Are we a little girl?
We are. Oh jeez, that is a lot of landmines.
Why are there boar
here.
On the?
Get out of here.
Oh my god! What is this?
And
oh,
now we fall storyline. Deep into the depths of the earth.
But we were so happy.
I know. All those butterflies are dead. Yeah, this is a big cave.
There's some stuff here going on. According to Merriam-Webster, an uncastrated male swine is a boar.
Oh, well, all right. Well, I guess we're, you know, it's sort of... Boars also don't talk or mine in caves, so I guess the fact that you're a girl boar is...
Come again? Liar.
Yeah. Well, as far as we know, they don't do that. So I guess the fact that you're a girl boar is not really the biggest stretch of this game. But yeah, this is sort of the setup where like you're reincarnated by this like whatever machine that is. And those things also end up serving as like your checkpoint things. Because the idea of the game is sort of, you know, you will like die or get stuck, and it's basically the point is like you are cloned a million times, and you know your clones are the ones that keep solving these puzzles. So
I'm
gonna go through this tutorial here.
Oh no! Was that you dying or was that like a checkpoint?
No, that was just a checkpoint. So this game, I love the personality of the boar. Like it actually has some really good expressions, and. I also think it's pretty interesting.
Board.
Yeah, you can do this sort of time traveling stuff. So, I guess let's go back up here and.
That's great. It's like the third game come out recently with like time traveling mechanics. It's like this, Super Time Force, and Transistor has some time mechanics.
Yeah, it seems like time is in these days.
In the indie scene, time.
Time's craze.
Will you have time for time?
Do you have time for full boar?
Yeah, I like that little like spin dash you do down. That is really cute. He's like adorable. Oh,
it's
she's adorable.
He, she. I don't know. Yeah, it's a male boar, but a female. I don't know. Whatever. This is the currency in the game. You're trying to collect these little square things, and. You basically...
Are you playing with a controller, my friend?
I am, sir. Probably should have mentioned that. Yeah, this game, I think it has keyboard controls, but I have not ventured to try them. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff. Like, you can see there's these, like, things up there that I can't reach. There's a lot of stuff that it sort of, you know, imply that you're supposed to come back and, you know, try and test your might. after you have some more skills.
Metroidvania boar game? Like it?
Yes, sir. There is some really Metroidvania stuff that's going to happen in a little bit. And I also like this, which is like, there's all these computer screens that have like notes about this like universe where, you know, it seems like there might have been some sort of human society down here that, you know, made these boars intelligent and also sort of created all this technology that I don't know why these boars are.
Are you going into space?
What they're doing, but yeah, apparently we're now taking a spaceship. I just love the little cartoon boar, he's so cute.
Yeah, I was just looking at the website. This was made by three people.
Yeah.
Casey Carlin, Finn Beasley, and Jake Frederico. And Finn Beasley is actually a cartoonist, so that explains the boar.
Okay, yep.
Jake Frederico is a mechanical engineer and apparently was a former competitive gamer.
Wow.
And it's changed in this. And also, it's pretty some competitive gaming. The programmer, Casey Carlin, had a computer science degree, and he worked for Arc System Works, the people who created Guilty Gear and BlazBlue.
Okay, well, there's no fighting mechanics in this game, but, you know.
Yeah.
Maybe later. I don't actually know. I haven't gotten that far. So we might find out.
The controls do seem very tight. Like, running is, like, definitely really fast, and it's, like, everything's really tight. And there's a boar talking to you?
Yeah, this is, like, the king or, like, the boss boar, so, like, it turns out that this guy's running this like mining operation. If you saw that, we ran a rocket ship right into his like his vault of money, and we messed up his thing. So now we have to work in his mines to pay off our debt. And I love this guy has a photograph of him sitting at his desk in his office.
In case
our
he
four
forgets.
Boar, there's a lot of like. I like it. It's sort of like that little My Little Pony type thing where they call like, you know, every boar or like four boar Dean is the foreman. It's kind of cute. I mean, I'm not really a big My Little Pony fan, but I don't think they invented either, that either. Adorable.
Boar puns.
So yeah, like you can full boar. Yep. We can go there and that's the way to go, but you can also like go in other directions and like, you know, try and solve. There might be puzzles down here. I don't remember. Let's see if we can solve this puzzle.
You kind of skimmed the controls, so what do you got? You got a jump, you have a stomp.
So I have this stomp is on X. I don't have a jump. I can basically, if I move left or right, I can, like, push against the objects, and then if I hold the right trigger, I can, like, jump upwards on objects, so they end up being, like, foreground elements, where usually you'll just sort of walk, like, either past them. Like, it depends on what, you know, the property of the item is. Like, I can also, like, dig up things, which either boxes that you might be able to use that I just ruined, so I'll go back. or you can dig up, you know, that dirt or rock or things like that. And you can get farther into that when we, I think we're gonna go into the mines now and check that stuff out. And I can do a little bit more boring. I think it's kind of unfortunate that they didn't call it full B-O-A-R, because if you call your game full bore, like, I don't know. It's kind of a negative connotation. Like, I don't want to be bored when I play a video game. Yeah. This game also has a great soundtrack, I think. And it does that little, you know, it shows you what track is playing there. So I don't know if they have a soundtrack available that you can buy, but I assume that's pretty useful, you know, if you want to know which song's which.
They actually
caught me red-hooved. The guy caught me red-hooved. So
yeah, an
that's
actual
what you need to know about this
incentive
game.
To buy the game was you got the soundtrack preview, and it's actually on their website. Apparently someone named the Objective Plurals were the people who made all the sounds for the soundtracks for this game, so they are very proud of their soundtrack.
Oh, cool. So that guy just pushed me into the mine and sort of trial by fire style here. Ooh,
oh no!
A little gem, nice.
Hey, money.
So that's some of that secret stuff, like those will fall down on you, but last time I played it, I didn't even notice that there was a gem in there, so like there's a lot of good little secret things where you can find items and stuff. What's that?
It doesn't hurt you or anything. It just kind of gets you all dirty.
Yeah, I just love this little guy. He's so great.
He's cute.
Little girl.
She's cute.
So we like can. Forget about it.
it's recorded.
If we do this stomp thing, you can sort of get rid of sand if it's, you know, not immediately next to you, which is useful. And so I can run around here. I found a secret area. So there's a lot of this where you are going to question marked areas that you might have to uncover. Let's see if there's anything down here. Sometimes, you know, it might just be set up for the later game. Like, there's also these parts where, like, you can see this little thing on the wall here, and sometimes there's, like, glyphs all around, so it seems like there might even have been, like, an alien. Whoa.
Yeah,
okay,
what
it
the
just
hell?
Teleported me, teleported me back. I don't know what's up with that. It seems like there might also be, like, a forerunner-type society that was, like, there before even the humans were there. Like, I don't really know what's up with the story yet.
Deep. You can go...
The full boar lore.
Boars. You can go
boars
in the four
deep.
Boar lore. Boars deep in the four boar lore. Lore boar. I am the lore boar. You fucked that up.
Did I? I think I can dig the... Yep, there we go.
There you go.
Yeah,
that's
a really simple puzzle there, but...
Adorable.
It's really
adorable.
They're adorable. I don't know. Let's give up on that.
Adorable.
So we can, like, a lot of these puzzles are pretty. Crap! I think I messed that up. So this sand will break if you even stand on it. So you sort of, you got to think about that because you can really. I mean, it's good that they put that time mechanic in there because I can't imagine how this game would work otherwise. Like, you can really paint yourself into a corner pretty quick. But also, you don't really need the gem things. Like, they're just sort of, you know, like a extra. I assume you can buy stuff later, but I don't know. It seems like just like a little skill thing that you can do.
Are there boars battles yet?
Boars battles? No, there are no bosses, whatever.
I say boars. So wait, what button is the changing time thing?
That is Y, and you can do sort of like a one step back, and then you can also go forward if you went back too far, or you can, I don't know what the, oh, I guess that goes back to the last checkpoint, if you press upwards. So, I don't actually know what we're supposed to do in this part.
That's adorable. Were you holding up the, are you holding it up? That's adorable.
Oh yeah, yeah, you can, this is a cute game.
Yeah, that's great.
Let's see, where am I, okay. There we go. I'm sure my terribleness at puzzles will come into play at some point here, so please forgive me for being bad at puzzle games sometimes, but I I don't play a lot of puzzle games, but this one has actually gotten me pretty into it.
The little push animation is adorable.
Let's see.
That's fine. You've had your moment in the limelight before. We gotta get back to games, seeing
me bad at games, show that I'm human.
Yes, human. You seem fine. Oh, you're trying to get that thing. Oh, what? Can you get that oyster out there?
I don't know.
Not anymore.
There's no way for me to get it. Yeah, No, because there's no way to get that block up to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's interesting about puzzle games such as this is that there's no set answer. It seems like there's multiple solutions to some problems. Because it's kind of in a way, a physics-based puzzle game.
Yeah. I mean, definitely a lot of... I mean, it's not actually like a physics engine, but there's definitely different physics associated with different...
Whoa!
Oh, yeah, that's my little super boar thing. Yeah, if you go through a bunch of rocks, like, to just compress the time, it'll do that. Okay, so here we go. This is the little Metroid-type thing that it'll do for you, where... Okay, so I got this, like, Game Boy thing, which is also my map. And I love that Zelda. Yeah, the Zelda, like, grab the thing. Yes.
You got the thing.
So here is, like,
nice.
The maps to the mines and stuff. And it is completely, I can't understand anything that's going on with these maps. Like, it doesn't actually help me to look at this and go, like, oh, that's where, you know, I got that gem or whatever. But it's kind of a nice little, it just shows you how much stuff you, how overwhelming the game is, basically. Oh.
Completely off subject, I started playing Fez for the first time recently.
Okay,
That map makes no sense.
Yeah, that's something about Fez. I think that's intentional that they don't want the map to make sense. So,
map
Fez is
madness.
A weird
I eventually
weird
figured
game.
It out.
Philfish.
Yeah, it's adorable. Philfish. Let's not talk about the fish. Can you get crushed by that? Will it damage
no,
you?
No, it'll just sort of, like, you'll have that little... cartoon look, and now you're kind of trapped in a corner. But you, I guess your head is like strong enough to hold it up. I just love the eyeballs when they look up at like the incoming boulder.
Yeah. Yeah, they must have gone through crazy amounts of animations in this game.
Yeah, I mean, I hadn't really looked it up, but it definitely makes sense that like a cartoonist was the person who actually, you know, did this stuff.
These
things, they'll sort of latch into different areas. And there's a lot of different puzzles. I'm going to jump out of here and go to my later save, which isn't too far in.
End game boar.
I mean, I'm 7% through the game in this save, but it's got a little bit more complex puzzles. So I think I had just found another way to go.
Oh, and here. You're the boy right now. That's why you look different.
Yeah, this is, I forget his name, but it's the boar. Boy boar.
Boy boar.
I'm sure everybody hates this at this point.
But we enjoy it. We're not doing stuff for our fans.
So this is some kind of, what is this? I went to sleep at this, like,
board trip
stone thing. Oh, I found another. Wow, I have not seen anything like this before. All right, so I want to see if I can fall off this edge here. Oh, yep. Yes, I can. No, oh, wow, I turned into a skeleton. All right. Jeez. Don't want to do that. So I don't know what these things do. Oh, they're teleporters. Okay. So, yeah, it'll tell you what level you're going to go to when you go to these things. I guess let's keep teleporting. The vault.
The vault.
The vault. Oh, the vault is where we started, right? That's the.
I like that you sleep.
So you can like use the right stick also to, like, look around and stuff. Oh, yeah, when you just go to sleep and. Yeah, it's another cute little boar thing you can do.
You sleep. Sleep your troubles away.
So this kind of rock is sort of like a little bit of like a foreshadowing thing, because you get to a point in the main mine where the guy goes, like, yeah, we don't dig farther than this. Like, we don't have the tools for it. So I assume that you can, at some point, dig farther than those rocks there.
You get, like, adamantium boar tusks.
Yeah. I don't know what to do at this point.
Yeah, you shouldn't have done
that. Oh, yeah, I trapped myself in a corner. Okay. So I should, what? Go here. I don't know what to do, actually. Oh, maybe I have to go backwards?
No, what you have to do is push over once. Push
like
that.
I don't think you can go up like that, though. Okay,
no.
You're right. So do that, and then go like this.
And then you can't do anything.
Oh, and then now I mess it up. Okay, yeah.
Maybe
we should go back to the other save where I am not terrible.
Well, the thing is, the issue is like that.
There we go.
Oh!
Okay, now we're doing something. All right.
Are we?
I don't know.
What you have, can you break that dirt?
Okay, I know what we have to do. We have to go back, and then...
You have to do that with that dirt block broken, it seems like.
I have to do it with the dirt block broken?
Can you go on that silver block and do it?
Well, let's see. So yeah, a lot of experimentation in this game. Oh, crap.
Nope. Right. You have to, see if you can destroy that from the side. And then try going on the silver block and doing it. Okay, and I'll go on that one and do it. There you go. And now you're fucked. Push that over. Eh? Go.
Damn it. Maybe
just do it quick. Yeah.
No, it doesn't let you actually... Maybe.
All right, then you have to...
Oh, yeah. I have to go down. Oh, no, that wouldn't... Oh, I think I know what to do. Okay, so we do this. And I think you can push...
What the fuck?
No, wait. Full boar! It's stumping us! I don't know. Let's go back to our other save. 2.82% is enough for us right now while we're trying to record the show. Alright. So, we shall go this way. And there's... Alright. So... Full boar has gotten the best of us. So grab some gems, do some boar stuff.
Do some full boar.
You can also make these things go even farther down, but that would trap me, so I'm not gonna do that. By stomping on them. Let's see. I think I can. Yep, do that and go. Okay, now I'm doing a little better. Look how good I am at full boar, guys. I'm so great at this game.
So
who said I couldn't solve a puzzle?
I didn't.
Certainly not.
I wasn't thinking of it.
If I do this, yep, There we go. Look at me. I'm getting gems. I'm doing good. We're doing good. Forget about that other save.
That's a dumb save.
Yeah,
this
was
is all
stupid.
Full bore action.
This is the real full bore.
So have you gotten any like Metroidvania-esque upgrades, like strict, like noticeable upgrades? Like, have you developed like a jump? Can you get one or something like that?
Not yet, but I wouldn't put it past this game. It seems like the type of thing it would do, right? I don't think I can get to that gem there, can I? I don't think so.
I'm looking up full bore stuff, but yeah.
Ooh. Let's keep digging down.
Dig. So how long were you playing it to get to that 7%?
Like a half hour or something. I had to say from a while ago that I got...
Is this a straight indie game, or is this a greenlit game?
It might have been greenlit, but it is an indie game. The company is called... I forget what the developer is called. It's called, like, something Hog, like Whole Hog Games.
Whole Hog.
Which is very, like... Hog. You're sort of really... You know, you have to make a specific type of game if you're going to be called Whole Hog Games, making games about boars.
It's their... But, you know, well, it's their first thing. Game, kind of. Yeah. There we go. Full Boar was greenlit.
Okay.
And...
Yeah, I mean, Greenlight's...
1.1 patch.
Greenlight is still an indie thing, though. Like, that's still, like... You know, it's not like Steam's fronting the money for anything when you greenlight, so it's still totally an indie experience. But yeah, good for them on Steam and all that.
Yeah, I was just curious of how they were discovered, really.
So that was a laser beam that we just used, and it just sort of put a big hole in the wall. Those things are simultaneously really fun to use, but also very devious because you can really mess up what you do with them, kind of. There's a lot of different ways you can use them. Oh, so here's this.
It's got a 70.
There's some boar back there.
That's not bad. 72 on Metacritic. Not bad.
This game's got a lot of heart, is what I find. And even when I'm sort of really screwing up with puzzles, like I just enjoy playing it because like these different characters and stuff. Like it's just a very pleasant game.
Yeah, and it's good for like a puzzle game. You want a puzzle game with a relaxing atmosphere, or else you're just gonna want to punch yourself in the face constantly.
Yeah, exactly. I have definitely punched myself in the face in this game at least once.
What's kind of weird, I'm getting a weird...
show, actually.
I'm getting a weird Oddworld vibe from this, are you?
Oddworld, wow, okay, maybe a little bit.
Like weird characters in like an underground mine and like a corrupt businessman. Like I'm getting just like Oddworld
vibes. Yeah, kinda. That's a good observation. Wow, I haven't thought about Oddworld in a long time.
That like cute slash creepy design of Oddworld that I'm kind of getting, and Tim Burton designed a boar.
I don't know if I'd go that far, but maybe yeah.
I'm just making claims, just bold claims, bold unsupported claims.
Tim Burton's full boar coming in 2016
by Clive Barker.
This is that area, by the way, that like it's as far as. You know, the boars have ever gone in the mine, but it's still like you can see that. Okay, I can't dig in this type of rock here because, you know, I just butt my head against it, but there are still things you can sort of do. Like you can see that if I look down, I don't think I can't use the stick to look down, but basically I can go like this. You can see that there's one of those batteries there, and those batteries on the right usually coincide with like a laser beam. Oh yeah, there's the laser beam. So I can actually do this, go all the way back up. I did figure this out. I'm not that bad at puzzle games. So I can go down this way and push this guy and sort of cheat this laser beam to go down. And you can see that like I just messed up my chances of going to that, you know, this area here. Like if I move this down farther, I won't be able to get to that. But every time you enter an area, it'll actually reset where all the stuff is, so you can, you know, it's not like you actually screw yourself in the long term.
Okay.
So, yeah, now I can go down with this thing, and the laser beam will go that way. What am I trying to do? Okay, so then I go here, and
laser beams.
Do this. Oh, wait, I might have messed that up.
You figure it out okay, once, yeah. You can do it again.
I figured it out once, yeah. So I can do that, and then this will actually be able to cut through this super strong rock. So, like, I find that there might be some sort of, like, secret stuff that you can do. Like, and now I can actually go farther down and, you know, try and explore the mine more. So, like, yeah, it seems like there's going to be a lot sort of to this game, and probably figuring out what's up with that map will end up coming in handy at some point.
Yeah, it seems like through a lot of the advertisement, it's like curiosity leads the way in Boar. Like, you're supposed to be... The whole game runs on not really... The story's probably interesting, but it's just more just like, ooh, can I go there? Like, it runs on that, like, ooh, can I do that mentality.
Right, yeah. Yeah, I definitely have had a lot of those moments where I look at, like, a gem and I go, like, well, how the hell do I get to that thing? You know, like, it really has that good, like, puzzle game thing that it gets your interest so quickly when you walk into a room, like, oh, crap, how am I going to even solve this puzzle, you know?
And that's a good puzzle, because then afterwards you play it again, you're like, of course. Yes. It's like one of those games where, like, as soon as your friend plays it, you're like, how could you not see the answer, you idiot? It's right there.
I'm sure everybody watching this who has played Full Boar was watching us do that one part, saying, how could you not see the answer, you idiot?
You stupid. They're really bored of us, then?
They are bored of this show. Here's this, like, alien, or maybe... prehistoric. It has something to do with humans and boars, we can see that, but they look like tall. They might be aliens. I mean, that guy on the right is a human, but, you know, that might, I don't know. And also, who wrote the hieroglyphics? If the humans were super intelligent, so it might have been a boar that made this, you know, or not hieroglyphics, yeah, right? Cave painting here. So I don't know.
I wouldn't put it past the boars to have paintings.
Yeah.
They seem very intelligent.
They seem, you know, they got their stuff together.
They got personality. Maybe they're all, maybe the humans tried to package them into meat products while working in the mines, and that's why they rebelled.
Oh, so here's like a little classroom with this.
Odd world references? No one? Huh?
So this is, right here is sort of a little, it kind of reminds me of Fez, where like on the chalkboard, it actually, it's telling you like what the different types of matter do, so like the block you can move left or right, the dirt's gonna fall down, you see that stuff, like, or the sand's gonna fall, the dirt's gonna check mark, it means it's gonna stay, and the stone is gonna fall. So that's like, if you can't figure it out by playing, like, that's a nice little, you know,
yeah,
environmental way of telling you what's what. It's
better than fucking stopping the game and a tutorial popping up,
right? Yeah. This is that. I still haven't figured out what I need to do with this guy.
Another rocket ship.
Yeah, he's trying
Who's
to build
that?
Something. Called me a green hoof.
Someone had a lot of... They all had a lot of fun writing the dialogue for this game.
Yeah, I'm sure they did. Yeah, I don't know what this guy needs, but... yeah, I mean, that's Full Boar. That's a pretty good, I mean, little cross-section of it. You could see how some of those puzzles might screw you. But, yeah. This game has a lot of charm, and I've been having a lot of fun with it.
What, where, and how much?
Well, let's find out. We've been doing this since you have been away
since
from Steampunk,
gone.
Sir. We have this new mechanic on the show where we show the Steam page. So,
first
yeah, singing some, yeah, sure.
Some of it, yeah, yeah.
Looks like, yeah, this machine, the recording machine, has been switched to Windows 8, and some of our settings is still just making us pay for music rights. YouTube has taken down this video. Alright, anyway, yeah, so we can't show the Steam page, but anyway, you can pick it up for $15. I'm trying to do the show, Pete. You can find it for $15
too,
on the Steam. You can get it for $15 on the Steam. And on the Avid. And yeah, I guess apparently you can get the soundtrack on their website, you said?
Yes, sir.
Alright, cool. And also, as I just found out, it has Steam cards. So if you're that type of person who likes Steam trading cards. Yeah, but it's a really charming
whole
game.
Wholehoggames.com, wholehog-games.com. No, -games.com.
There you go. So yeah, if you liked what you just watched of us being terrible at puzzle games, and if you don't like us being terrible at puzzle games, you might want to watch us playing different types of games. We play all different types of games on Steampunk. So on the left is a game called freaking meat bags that me and Chris were playing last week.
I'm pissed I missed it.
Yeah, that was an interesting game. So it's sort of a... It's a tower defense mixed with, like, an RTS. So, you know, you're sort of making your little grunt units, and they're basically, like, SCVs, like, going out and collecting resources and stuff, and then you do your tower defense stuff there, where you're sort of, you know, making attack, you know, weapons and all that stuff.
You said, actually, in that one, your robots defending against humans, right? Something like that?
Yeah, it's like the humans are the grunt thing, so you can see them there, and the robots are just, like, you know, they're the corporation, you know, guys that are trying to, you know, make money on mining and stuff. It's a nice little, like, flip the script thing where the humans are regarded as just idiots. Like, they're really lazy and stupid, and, like, you need to, like, put mind slugs on them to, like, control them and all this stuff. It's pretty funny. And on the top right, you can see the game that I have recently been obsessed with, Dark Souls 2. And we show the PC version of that game, which is just stellar. I love Dark Souls. You can see me battling it out to the death with a Dark Phantom there.
Yeah, you gave yourself a good part.
Yeah, I don't die in that little thing, and you can watch the show to find out whether or not I die fighting him in the episode. That was a nice long episode there too. Ooh. If you like Dark Souls, check that out. I don't do terribly in that one. And on the bottom right, you can see an episode that Pete was on. Which was a game called Rogue Shooter, the FPS roguelike, which is just like it sounds.
I did download the demo and I did play that game. Very fun.
Yeah, it's a really weird combination of, like, you know, like Wolfenstein 3D type, you know, first person shooter, you know, sprite based and all that stuff, and it's got, like, these really deep RPG mechanics in it. But it works. It's super strange and it's a roguelike and really unforgiving, but yeah, it's a lot of fun. So yeah, make sure to subscribe on YouTube if you haven't already, and check out all of our social media links there, and visit us at pressplaytv.com. But before we go, How Do I Jump does have their new website up and running, and Pete, you want to take it away and tell the people about How Do I Jump? What's going on with you guys?
Yeah, we're doing a lot of awesome news. We got a second season of Indie Interviews going up. Just check us out at hd1jump.com, hd1jump.com, and also the same handle for Twitter for some awesome news updates and weekly podcasts that Mr. Harlick frequents pretty much every week. Yeah, but yeah, it's a good time. We video game news and fun, charismatic people.
Awesome. Well, until next week, guys. Keep it steamy.
Such a matter, I just can't take it. I can't. Please end the podcast.
This is a very musical episode. I like it.
I'm a very musical person.